Hi everyone, I wanted to share some of the ways that you can find subtitles on YouTube or add subtitles to any videos that you wanted to use on YouTube. When you're looking for videos on YouTube, I tend to go to one of a few places, TED-Ed being one of them. TED-Ed is the educational division of the TED organization, and they make videos for classroom use that tend to be between 3 and 6 minutes long, and almost all of them have captions. You can tell that TED videos or any YouTube video has actual captions on it because it'll say something like English or Hebrew, or it'll say English with TED-Ed after it. So TED-Ed is very useful with its captions because, as you can see, the captions that are scrolling across the bottom of the screen are exactly what's being said in the video. But most YouTube videos aren't like that. For example, I've used videos from the channel Dr. Mike Evans. This video could be used for our athletes or in health class or even for our athletes' parents about concussions. But when you click on the captions button, it says English automatic captions. Automatic captions on YouTube means that Google's voice recognition software is listening to the audio that's playing and then translating it into script that goes across the bottom of the screen. Unfortunately, I've experienced where YouTube's automatic caption software works for maybe a sentence or two, but it doesn't do well with accents, and sometimes it'll just throw in random words that aren't actually part of what's being said. When that happens and I still want to use a video, I scroll down to the share box and I copy the web address that's in that box, and then I go to a website called Amara. Amara.org is a wonderful place because you can translate videos from services like Vimeo, YouTube, anything that's recorded in HTML5, and it's easy to sign up for because you can sign in using a Google, a Facebook, Twitter, Udacity, TED, or you can just sign up for a normal Amara account. Now, I happen to use my Google account for Amara because it's also linked to my YouTube account. So when I want to add a video, I simply right-click in the Add a Video section and paste the web address that I copied from YouTube and click Subtitle. So this is the workspace for your video, and what it does is it allows you not only to subtitle a video, but also you can add a new language of subtitles if you were trying to work with your LEPs. You can upload any subtitles, and then you can share your video with its subtitles through Facebook, Twitter, and email. So I'm going to click Subtitle Me. Let's see if I can find American English. There it is. So there's the video, English subtitle. Click Continue. And it'll take you to the actual place where you add subtitles to this video. So, if you're unfamiliar with the Amara interface, there are always tutorial videos, and what it does is it gives you the keys on the back. So, for example, Tab to play pause. You can Shift Tab to skip back about 4 seconds, or Shift Enter to do a line break. So, for example, let me press Tab and show you how this works a little bit. So once you press enter on Amara, you've entered a new window and you can continue subtitling like that. Once you begin, you finish subtitling all your words, you click Start Syncing. And once you press the Tab key to start here, you press the Down key. Now, if I had added all my subtitles, I would continue subtitling, and then you review and complete. You can save it part of the way through. You can exit if you wanted to, right? If it's discarding my changes, which is good because I don't want to subtitle the whole video at this time. And once you're finished, you can have a video address through your Amara account where you can access the subtitles that you've created and show the video or share the link to the video with any of your students or parents who would be interested in seeing that video with subtitles. For those of us who teach deaf and hard of hearing students, this would be the primary URL that you would use to show the video to your students. So, now that I've shown you this video, what I'm going to do is save this video, upload it to my YouTube channel in the general playlist, and then show you how to subtitle a video using YouTube's own caption editing software.